Hello everyone and welcome to the course of Mechanical System Design, in which we are learning about design of IC engine components. In the last lecture we learned design of connecting rod, and especially we learned about shank of the connecting rod, and in this lecture we will learn about the ends, bearing cap and bolts of the connecting rod. We have already seen basics of the connecting rod in previous lecture. What we are learning over here is the forces which are responsible for detrimental stresses on the ends of the connecting rod. A piston pin is inserted inside the small end of the connecting rod, whereas a crank pin of a crankshaft is assembled inside the big end of the connecting rod. The gas force from piston is transferred to the piston pin. This force is transferred to the shank of the connecting rod, and then it is transferred to the crank pin. If you see transfer of this force, then it is not very detrimental to the ends of the connecting rod, since small end, the bottom half of the small end of the connecting rod, is supported by the material of the shank, and same is the case for the upper half of the big end of the connecting rod. Thus, gas force is not responsible for the failure of the ends of the connecting rod. However, it is the inertia force of the reciprocating masses which is responsible for inducing higher stresses and failure of the small end as well as big end of the connecting rod. Let us understand from where these inertia forces will arise. When piston is moving towards TDC, then both piston and connecting rod will have upward motion. After reaching the top dead center, the crank will pull the connecting rod downward. However, the piston will continue to move upward, which will induce inertia force on the upper half of the small end. The crank pin will resist this motion and it will induce the inertia force on the bottom half of the connecting rod. The bottom half of the big end of the connecting rod is called as big end bearing cap. Thus, the inertia force is the most important force when it comes to the design of ends of the connecting rod, which is denoted by FImax in this diagram. Now let us move on to understand the design of the connecting rod. First, we will design the small end of the connecting rod. Over here, DP is the diameter of the piston pin which will be inside the small end of the connecting rod. DPI is the inner diameter of the small end, and DPO is the outer diameter of the small end. The blue colored part is the bearing bush inside the small end of the connecting rod. The inner diameter of the small end is denoted by DPI, and it is calculated as DP plus twice the thickness of the bearing bush. If this thickness is 2 mm, then DPI is equal to DP plus 4, where DP is the diameter of the piston pin. Now, the most important part, let us calculate maximum tensile force acting on the connecting rod, which is maximum inertia force. It is given by Fi max equal to mr omega square r cos theta plus cos 2 theta upon n0. In this formula, mr is the mass of reciprocating components, omega is the angular speed of crankshaft in radian per second, r is the radius of the crank, theta is the angle turned by crank from TDC, which can be observed over here. N0 is the obliquity ratio, which is given by L by R, where L is the length of the connecting rod and R is the radius of the crank. The inertia force will be maximum when piston is at TDC. That means at this point, theta will be 0 or 360 or 720 and so on. For all these values of theta, cos theta and cos 2 theta will be equal to 1, and we get a shorter version of the formula of maximum inertia force. The tensile stress induced due to this force is given by sigma pt equal to force upon area. Now the resisting cross section area for this force is rectangular in shape over here. And we have such two areas available for the resistance. The area which is resisting is the difference in the diameter, that is dpo minus dpi into L1, which is the width of the small end of the connecting rod. Another formula over here, sigma pt is the allowable stress in the material. This is the inertia force. Dpo has to be calculated. Dpei we have already calculated in the previous step, and L1 is also calculated. Thus dpo is the only unknown and it can be derived. There exists one more empirical formula for the calculation of dpo given by 2dp. Thus we will have two values of dpo, one from the derived formula and one from the empirical formula, and higher value out of these two formulae will be considered for the design. Let us understand the design of big end. It is split into two half. First half, upper half, is integrated with the shank of the connecting rod, and lower half is called as bearing cap. They are clamped together with the help of a nut bolt arrangement, which are separated by a distance S. DB is the nominal diameter of the bolt. LBC is the length or the width, or in other dimension it is the thickness of the big end of the connecting rod. DCP is the diameter of the crank pin which will be assembled inside the big end. DCI is the inner diameter of the big end. TCO is the outer diameter of the big end. First we have to calculate diameter of the crank pin denoted by DCP. It is calculated by the consideration of bearing forces. The bearing force is equal to the bearing pressure into area resisting this bearing pressure. So it is given by FG max, which is maximum gas pressure into cross section area of the piston. The bearing area is the projected area inside the big end given by length of the bearing into diameter of the crank pin. LBC can be taken as 1 to 1.5 times of diameter of a crank pin. Thus we can express LBC in terms of DCP. FG max can be calculated from peak firing pressure. PB is the material property, which is permissible bearing pressure between the crank pin and the connecting rod bearing, which is taken at 7 to 8 Newton per mm square for splash lubrication bearing and 8 to 12 Newton per mm square for pressure lubrication bearing. Thus only DCP is the unknown in this formula and it can be calculated. Inner diameter of the big end is denoted by DCI, and it is calculated geometrically as DCI equal to DCP plus twice the thickness of the bearing shell. If this thickness is 3 mm, then DCI is equal to DCP plus 6. Let us understand the design of the bearing cap. Thickness of the bearing cap is denoted by TBC. The inertia force will act at the center of the bearing, and it is supported by the bolt at two ends. The reaction at the two bolts is exactly half of the maximum inertia force given by Fi max upon 2. Thus, bearing cap is a simply supported beam subjected to point load at the center. The failure mode of a bearing cap is due to the bearing bending stress. The bending stress in the bearing cap is given by My upon I, which comes from the flexural formula, where M is the maximum bending moment, Y is the distance of the farthest fiber from the neutral axis, and I is the area moment of inertia of cross section of a bearing cap. We know that for a simply supported beam subjected to point load, maximum bending moment is WL by 4, where W is the force, L is the distance between two reactions or the length of the beam upon 4. By applying that formula, maximum bending moment is Fi max into S upon 4. The distance of the farthest fiber from neutral axis is TBC upon 2. Area moment of inertia is given by BD cube by 12, where B is the width of the cross section and D is the depth of the cross section. So in this case, width of the cross section is LBC and depth of the cross section is TBC upon 12. By simplifying this formula, we get this final value. Sigma BC depends upon the material. Fi max is already calculated. LBC is again known for the given connecting rod. S is the distance between two bolts, which can be taken as 1.75 to 2 diameter of the crank pin. Thus, in this formula, only TBC, that is thickness of the bearing cap, is the unknown, and it can be calculated. Outer diameter of big end of the connecting rod is denoted by DCO, and it is given by DCI plus 2 TBC. Bolts are subjected to this inertia force, so they have to resist the failure due to tension induced by this inertia force. So this is the applied inertia force, and it is resisted by strength of the material of the bolt into cross section area of the bolt, and such two cross sections are available, hence the number 2 is over here. In this formula, DC is the core diameter of the bolt from which nominal diameter can be calculated, and sigma TB is the strength of the material of the bolt. Let us solve the same numerical example which we were solving in the last lecture to understand these concepts. For the ease of understanding, various notations are already mentioned wherever some data is available. You may pause this video to go through this problem statement carefully so that you are aware of the data which is already available to solve the problem. We have already solved question number 1 and 5 in the last lecture. So in this lecture, we will focus on question number 2, 3 and 4. First, we have to calculate dimensions of the small end, and for that we have to calculate dimensions of the piston pin diameter. Piston pin diameter is calculated based on the formula of bearing pressure given by Fg max equal to L1 dp pb. If you note the given data, L1 is given as 1.5 times dp, thus only dp is the unknown in this equation, which can be calculated as 30 mm, and L1 can be calculated as 45 mm. Inner diameter of the small end, DPI, can be calculated by this formula, and thickness of bearing push is given as 3 mm, so DPI comes out to be 36 mm. Outer diameter of the small end of the bearing is a critical calculation which is based on calculation of the maximum inertia force. So let us calculate it first by this formula given in the box, where MR is the mass of reciprocating components, which includes mass of a piston and 1/3 mass of a connecting rod. So it is MP plus 1/3 mass density of material of a connecting rod into volume of the shank. Volume of the shank can be calculated as cross section area AC of the shank into length of the connecting rod, which comes out to be Okay, if mass of piston is not readily known, unlike this problem, then you can model the piston based on the dimensions which you have achieved. In any 3D modeling software, assign material properties to that model so that mass of a piston will be known to you. Omega is the angular velocity in radian per second, which can be obtained from angular velocity given in RPM. R is the crank radius, which can be calculated as L by 2, that is stroke by 2. N0 is the obliquity ratio, which is the ratio of connecting rod length to the crank radius. Now don't get confused between capital L and small l. Capital L is the stroke of the engine, whereas small l is the length of the connecting rod. By putting all these values, maximum inertia force comes out to be 6308.15 Newton. Now DPO can be calculated by using the formula of stress induced in the small end of the connecting rod. Again, all the data is known to you except sigma pt, which is already given, but we have to calculate it as the strength of the material divided by factor of safety 4. From this formula, DPO is calculated as 38 mm, and from the empirical formula, DPO is calculated as 60 mm. This being the higher value, DPO is considered as 60 mm. Let us now calculate dimensions of the big end of the bearing. So first we have to calculate the diameter of the crank pin from the consideration of bearing forces, which comes out to be DCP equal to 36 mm, and length of the connecting rod, big end of the connecting rod, comes out to be 45 mm. The inner diameter of the big end, that is DCI, is equal to DCP, that is diameter of the crank pin plus twice the thickness of the bearing bush, which comes out to be 42 mm. Thickness of the bearing cap is calculated based on the bending stress given by this formula. Let us see, is there any new term to be calculated in this formula? So sigma BC is the material property, that is allowable bending stress, which is the limiting stress in the material divided by factor of safety 4. S, which is the distance between two bolts, is considered as 1.75 times diameter of the crank pin. Rest all the values are known to us, with the help of which we can calculate thickness of the bearing cap as 12 mm. Now the outer diameter of the bearing or the big end is DCO given by DCI plus twice thickness of the bearing cap, which comes out to be 66 mm. By an empirical formula, DCO comes out to be 54 mm. 66 mm is chosen being the higher value. Diameter of the bolt of a bearing cap is calculated using the formula of equilibrium of inertia forces and the resisting forces. In this formula, again all the values are known. Sigma TB, the material for bolt is different, so it comes out to be 450 divided by 5 as mentioned in the problem statement. This DC is the only unknown and it can be calculated at 6.68 mm. A nominal diameter of the bolt is calculated as DC divided by 0.84, which comes out to be 7.95, which is approximated to 8 mm. With this, the design of the end, bearing cap and bolts of the connecting rod is over. We have already designed shank of the same connecting rod in the previous lecture, and with this, design of the entire connecting rod is also over. I request all the viewers to practice this problem to understand the concepts clear. If you find this channel interesting, please subscribe to it. If you find this video useful, please like it, share it. If you have any questions, any suggestions, any feedback, then please comment it on the video. Thank you.